nice here. Be nice, guys. Hold on. Hold on.
Boogity, boogity, boogity. Let's go racing, boys.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Sonoma. This is actually my second attempt at this race because I just tried doing it in one attempt, except I forgot to turn off the full quote unquote face lap and the. And I forgot to turn off yellow flags because. Yeah. There will be no cautions during this race. It's just going to be a short 25 lap sprint race. No pun intended on it being the Toyota Sprint 350. So far, Bryce Ryles is dominating by being on pole, followed by Ray Takeda, Paul Bledsoe. I don't know. It's been a. Yeah. There we go. Okay. So we got Ryles on pole, Takeda is second. Bledsoe, Campbell, Hernandez,
drivers,
Vaughn, Arioco, Crago, Bishop, and Manigan. And. Here are the rest of your qualifying results. Ignore Fred Jones, please. As we get set to go racing here. Again, it will be 25 laps. Looks like the wind's heading south-southeast at relatively low speed. And it's a nice, clear, crisp, chilly afternoon of a wonderful 76 degrees. As a couple of the colored pencils that are in my lamp fell over. If you heard that, if not, then I am explaining an imaginary noise that. Whatever. Anyways, time to go racing. Damn, missed it. Oh well. And as the pace car immediately pulls off to. And as the pace car serpentines its way into pit row. Oh, wait, hold on. Did somebody not get started back there? Huh, Jackie Ting's immediately heading to pit road. Let's redo this. Because I want everybody to fucking start the race. Even if everybody won't finish the race. Here we go. We're gonna get the command for one.
Start your engines.
Well, that was a lame excuse of a freaking. Wrong button. I'll just give you the. I'll let you guys see the frame counter just to show you just how shitty my frames are at a track like this. Green flag is out, we are underway at Sonoma. No major wrecks so far. The first turn is relatively clean. They head up through the first set of S's down into turn number four. That's not turn four, that's turn four. There we go. Bryce Ryles takes the early lead. Reed Takeda takes second. Here comes Skylar Campbell now taking third for Paul Bledsoe as they hit single file down into turn number five. Trigger with a huge run as he's now side by side with fellow Arizonian RJ Bishop. Luis Hernandez takes fifth away from Ryan Vaughn, will be in helicopter for most of this race, by the way. Them running through the S's now. Here they come into the hairpin. Here comes Skylar Campbell trying to take second away from Ray Takeda. However, she can't quite get there. Riles will lead the first lap. After a heartbreak last week at Knockford, here he is right back where he started at Knockford. Well, at least the middle portion of the race. With Ray Tekeeta right behind him, Skylar Campbell right behind her. Of course, the Ducati 500 winner, Paul Bledsoe, in fourth, and Luis Fernandez in fifth. Finally, good run for that 42 car. We are, after all, at a road course, as we see some side-by-side racing back here. Last week's winner, Miles Lightheart, once again, not very good at road course. It is amazing that he won at Old Spice Raceway earlier this season. Which, by the way, Old Spice is a road course. Back up front, Bryce Riles is pulling away from the field. Looks like Craig has lost a few spots. This field's relatively sorting itself out for now. All 41 cars single file, so you know it's going to be a bull fest. At least relatively a bull fest. They head up through turns. Actually, wait, hold on. Technically, that was turn 5 that I said it was turn 4 back in. Anyways, working away around turn 3 and 4 right now. Down the hill to turn number 5. And into turn 6 they come. Out of turn 6, they lead. I don't know, this is probably like turn 12 or something. I'm trying to count exactly how many turns there are in this track. In fact, look. I'm going to ignore what it says here. 1, 2, 3. Oh, wait, no. Oh, that was turn 1. This is turn 2. Turn 3, turn 4, turn 5, 6. I don't know where they're getting this 7 from. Excuse me, 13 turns. I think that's most of any track so far. And it looks like Shinnaro Yoko is under fire from RJ Bishop now. RJ Bishop loses ground now, but he had, almost had it. Same song, different verse. Max versus Onesto. And now Diaz is now battling the Max as they go into the hairpin. Turn 13. Max now side by side with Alan Bledsoe. Oh, and RJ Bishop has blown up! The number 98 Dodge has lost his engine. As he quickly loses positions as he distracts his car through the dirt in an effort to stay out of the way of the rest of the field. As they head through turn 12, down into turn number 13. You know, this race is relatively calm compared to the first one where we had a huge wreck entering turn one. And the caution was called because of it. Man, what a heartbreak for the number 98. And he was doing so good, he has started every race that he's entered since Bristol. He's not dead last in the standings, amazing enough. In fact, he's actually ahead of Luis Hernandez, who started every race, including this one. Hernandez, of course, is currently fifth. Brian Vaughn, sixth. Shinya Ryoko is now 7th, Kanika Mannigan is now 8th, Craigo is now 9th, and Cody Lamas is now 10th. Max now battles the 26 of Asami Honorunami. And it was a piston that they're saying on the number 98 car. Warren's now not being very quick. Her head down to number 6. Skylar Campbell side by side with Brady Keita, but Keita gets the run off of the outside, technically, of the corner. Bryce Riles is making his way to turn 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I hit the wrong button. Sorry, folks. That's a bet you if I turn cautions on, cautions would be, you know, every lap, but spread out right now. Side by side down, battle between the Max and Bledsoe, and behind them, Onami and Onesta. Mommy takes the spot host. Nestle now under fire from Diaz. Lucero got the spot over to Max. Ishtar side by side with Lomas. The 88 side by side with the 09. 88 takes the spot. The 48 and 33 are still side by side. Merrick commences the pinch. Lomas down. Merrick Ishtar now takes the 10th spot. Born currently running 23 seconds behind the leader in 40th. Just to give you an idea of how spread out the field is. Give you an idea. Quick Born is entering the S's by the looks of it by the time that Bryce Riles is leading. That's how far 23 seconds is. Back around, let's see how far back it is now. 23.53 seconds. Or 35 seconds, you know what I meant. Skylar Campbell's running a really great race after her debut back at Old Spice, which wasn't all that good, but now she's running up near the front after having earned somewhat. This is her sixth race of the season, and she's actually doing really well in this one, so that's good for her. Riles is still leading laps and still running up front. Reed Akita is doing well. Paul Bledsoe is finally having some luck after his win in the 2x500. Luis Hernandez is having a phenomenal run in relation to where he is at points. Ryan Vaughn's just still being consistent. Shin Arioko is doing well. Kattigan Mannigan is doing well. Craig is, well, he's being somewhat consistent. Merrick Ishtar is doing really well. Oh! Lomas gets turned by... Oh! And he jumps the grass, too! Oh! And Eleanor Rose now! Is... Holy shit, is she actually way to the inside of the... As she now just boops into the tire barrier. What happened to Eleanor Rose? Oh, Leia Walker. Just outright dumpster. Barely missed the tire barrier there. As for Lomas, I saw... Oh my gosh, he actually got dumped by his Sato teammate there. He hops the grass and gets back into him. Holy crap! And we have a larger wreck than anticipated due to this. Payback's a bitch when it happens here at Sonoma. Lomas almost get, and he does get turned by Leia Walker. Finally, some excitement halfway done into this race. Just when he thought Lomas was gonna have a semi-good run for once. Oh, what happened to Luke Walker? Did he pit? Yeah, Luke Walker just flat out pitted. That brings up the question on whether or not people can make it now on fuel. My God. Eleanor Rose is currently on pit road. The 09 does have a little bit of damage. 48 obviously has a bunch of damage. 16 is now battling him for what's no longer pretty much last place on track. 48, of course, pulls away. But talk about excitement when one gets the rear bumper of another and just sticks there. But talk about payback being a bitch for... who was it? The 88? Yeah. Chase Carpenter just got humbled by the 48 coming back across the track. But it was otherwise somewhat of a good save there up until the 48 got back into the 88. However, with the 09 having pitted, does that bring up the question on whether or not these guys need to make a pit stop, as we see Eleanor Rose now making her way down pit road? Two laps down. Officially about to go third. Yeah, right there. Because these guys are going 25 laps. In fact, it will be 10 to go next time by. Looking at the ticker here. Riles and Kyle Corbett in the number 99 signing a deal to work together on a team next season. Looks like Eleanor Rose will only be two laps down for the remainder of the race. So far, only the 98 has retired, as we see the 21 now trying to get up to the quarter panel 59. As we got about 9.5-ish laps to go. Did see damage on the foot area of the 40 of the 09, as we see the 16 has now gotten around the 48. So makes me wonder if the 09 maybe pitted to repair some damage or something along those lines. Breakthrough after, I don't know, two or three attempts now. I actually have to check the official points statistics and whatnot. Kagan Mannigan goes wide. This will open the door up for the 62 potentially. Or not, since 62 pulls away. Or, well, Kagan Mannigan pulls away. Thank you. looks like Ryle Campbell and Tejeda has actually pulled away from Vaughn, Hernandez, and the rest of the field. Alvarado seems to be pulling away from the one car, though, so even less damage, so that's basically giving up the middle finger to aerodynamics, right? About this angle is it shows the cars coming up through the S's up into turn six in the background. I said I was going to be in this new helicopter view most of the race. Side-by-side battles here. The Max still trying to get a blood cell between the spot. Six against the five. Here comes the 31 into 32. Kind of gets pinched down. Wrong direction. It's nice at the one back bumper. Tejeda pulls away. Oh, whoops, I forgot to turn the stick back on. Giving an idea, the 09 is 46 seconds. So we're 3/4 of a minute behind the 1. As the 09 exits turn 2, Ryles is 10 turns ahead of Luke Walker. So there's that. Race has been. It doesn't feel like it's been all that long. Yeah, just over half an hour. So this race will still go longer than fucking Las Vegas. God damn, seriously. Las Vegas was literally 32 minutes and change. We're at half an hour now, and we still got 6 laps left. And these lap times are over a minute and 20 seconds long. So, okay. Under a minute and 20. Just, okay, over a minute and a quarter long. Whatever. Close enough. Oh, then. Campbell actually had a faster lap time than. Oh, wow. Ryan Vaughn actually had a faster lap time than these three. So he's catching. Hell, Eleanor Rose even had a faster lap time than Ryles. By 0.3 seconds. Damn, Ryan Vaughn's catching. He is catching. What's the lap time of these guys this time by? 19.7, 19.9, 20. And 19.3, Ryan Vaughn is indeed catching these guys. 19.6, of course. Wow, Cody Lawless is actually falling off the pace here. As we see side by side battle between Leia Walker and job, Joel Michaels, as the 31 has finally gotten around in the 32 for 11. Campbell side by side with Takeda. Well, not anymore, but she was. This allows Royals to pull away. We're coming up on four laps to go. It's currently a three-car battle, will it become a four-car battle? Amy Liu has pitted. 19.6. Ryan Vaughn is still catching. He's going to get held up by the 73. That's not good for Vaughn. Amy Liu has, for some reason, pitted. Is there anybody else on pit road? No, there is nobody else on pit road. Does that mean these guys can make it? Does that mean these guys can't make it? Skylar Campbell's going for second. 3.5 laps to go. Nikita defends the spot, but they're still side by side. Nikita manages to pull away, entering turn 11. Okay, lap times, 20.4, 20.7, 20.7, 27.1, 20.5, that's right, 20.5, and yeah, he lost time due to that. Looks like Amy Liu is actually a little bit faster than these guys, due to the fresh tires and whatnot. No, nobody pitted. Can these guys actually make it? Or is it just a ploy by the 73 for pitting for no apparent reason? Only time will tell. They're all right on the back bumper of each other. Campbell looking to the inside of Takeda, going through the hairpin. Now she's on the inside of Riles. Side by side, down into the front straightaway. We have two laps to go. Campbell leads at the line and takes the lead. Riles is slow for some reason. Something is amiss on the one car. As Campbell is looking to possibly take the win. A lap and a half to go for Campbell. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Has the 09 actually passed the 48? The 09 has passed the 48. Wow. Something is amiss on the one car, though, to have been passed that easily by the 21. Amy Liu's now gonna try to pass the 59. Thank you. doesn't. Here comes Ray Tejeda now trying to get by the one possible contact. Less than a lap to go for Skylar Campbell. A 119.5 compared to a 123.1. And now Ryan Vaughn has caught Tejeda and Riles in the battle for second. Campbell over 3 seconds ahead of Riles, Tejeda, and Vaughn. Out of turn number 6 and into turn number 7 they go. However, it's all Campbell right now. For the second week in a row, Bryce Riles will see the lead disappear in a race that he dominated and beat the bridesmaid. Once again, Skylar Campbell will win at Sonoma. In fact, Riles won't even be the bridesmaid. It will be Ray Tejeda as Riles edges Vaughn for third. As the field cycles around. Huh, 78? Or 71? Must have made a pit stop or something. So we just wait for Eleanor Rose to finally cross the start and finish line. It's the way I can export the results, obviously. But what a heartbreak for Riles once again. Second race in a row where he's dominated the event and then sees the lead disappear right before his eyes in the closing stages of the race. Didn't he start on pole too? Yeah, he started on pole, which makes it even more heartbreaking. I mean, yeah, tough luck for RJ Bishop down here, who started, like, what, in the top 10 and, ninth, and will finish dead last due to piston braking. But Riles starts on pole, dominates the event, and just barely finishes third. After the tough break last week, and now on to this. Certainly will help him in points, though, after missing a race back at Armory Digital, I think? Anyways, but Skylar Campbell gets the win over, I think she's too far back in points to currently qualify herself in the chase. I'm pressing the wrong button. There we go. To qualify herself in the chase. However, she has runs like that. She will eventually become a chase contender. So that's all from Sonoma. It's on to Richmond, I believe, for the next race of the season. I opened the wrong notepad. Martinsville. My bad. Martinsville and then Richmond. So that's all from Sonoma. We'll see you at Martinsville, folks.